helping one another to realize financial ambitions in a cooperative of which clients may be members as well as owners. That is the principle of Rabobank, strongly anchored in its genes. This cooperative principle dates back to the mid-1800s. The situation in rural Germany is frightful. Many farmers are on the verge of poverty. Mayor Friedrich Wilhelm Raiffeisen comes up with a solution: a credit union with farmers as owners and members. Farmers deposit their savings to provide loans to other farmers. They in turn get credit on reasonable terms.
Het zijn de boerenleenbanken die ervoor zorgen dat dit ook gebeurt. Ze kunnen het, omdat ze niet uit zijn op winst, nog uitsluitend de algemene welvaart op het platteland willen bevorderen.
Around the turn of the century, there is an urgent need for agricultural modernization in the Netherlands. But it is almost impossible to get a loan with favorable conditions. Taking Raiffeisen's lead, agricultural credit cooperatives are founded all across the Netherlands.
De boer zou dan ook niets aan zijn geld hebben gehad als hij er niets mee had gedaan.
A farmer is a member of a local bank, and a number of members are voted onto the board. This makes the farmer client, member and owner of the bank.
En hier is dan zo'n plaatselijke boerenleenbank.
In the early years, the credit cooperatives don't look much like today's banks. Often the banks are just little rooms in the cashier's house or in a bar. And they are open for business just a few hours a week. In 1910, there are 600 of these local independent agricultural credit cooperatives. And in 1920, their number has already grown to 1100. So farmers and market gardeners never have to go far to join a credit cooperative and get a loan. From the very beginning, there is an idea of cooperation between the independent banks, with a view to knowledge accumulation, central investments, and proper supervision. This comes to pass in two coordinating organizations, the Cooperative Central Raiffeisen Bank in Utrecht and the Cooperative Central Boerenleenbank in Eindhoven. Cooperations as organizations are popular in the agricultural world. Almost every town has a local cooperative dairy factory, purchasing association, or abattoir. After the Second World War, Dutch society drastically transforms, as does the role of banks. Non-agricultural entrepreneurs, such as retailers, become clients and members. Pay packets are replaced by transfers into bank accounts, and this attracts many new private clients. By the late 60s, almost every household has a bank account. New payment options are introduced, such as certified checks, acceptance gyros, and automatic transfers. Another new thing are personal loans and mortgages. Money as a way to realize one's dreams, such as a car, new furniture, or a house. The cooperative agricultural banks professionalize to be able to cope with these changes. They open their own offices with multiple staff members, almost always situated in the heart of the village.
De Raiffeisenbanken hebben zich uitgesproken voor een fusie met de Boerenleenbank.
Instead of competing, the two central organizations merge in 1972, creating Rabobank, a cooperative bank for everyone. The merger enables the extension of services, with different group entities to handle investments, insurance and leasing. Clients strike out internationally, and Rabobank follows suit, with branches in countries like the United States, Germany, Brazil, Australia and New Zealand. Rabobank becomes one of the biggest and most important financiers in the international food and agricultural industries. In the Netherlands, Rabobank offers private and corporate clients a wide variety of financial products. More and more, banking is done online. Rabobank is at the forefront of this trend. From being the first bank to have a website, to providing a complete online banking environment. A natural consequence of this is the need for less brick-and-mortar offices. At the same time, this raises the question whether this might cost Rabobank its characteristic of always being nearby. But then a bank that is always open and available by phone or computer is in fact closer than ever. Another debate is the one about the cooperative as an organisation in times of more monitoring and stricter rules, times when central control and surveillance are required. Can a local bank and its members still have any social impact? The cooperative principle isn't up for discussion, but the implementation is. This changes with the times, with attention to making food, housing, energy, and running a business more sustainable, together with members and clients. Working together towards a better world is still manifest in the genes of the bank and its members. For people working together is what makes the cooperative Rabobank. You wanna be where everybody knows your name. Then, now, and in the future.